Even if you do not completely understand, you might have to, you will have to obey what the parents
said.
We have Amachi here whose husband has gone to be with the Lord, but because they had raised their children right, they are able, we are here today and we're able to stand, they are all able to stand in the Lord. The church members all need to be unified of oneness of mind. The pastors and the believers need to be unified in spirit. But the whole, but instead, the enemy is trying to make divisions among them. Oh, no matter where it comes from, we need to understand that it comes from the evil spirit, and we need to fight against it. When there is unity, there is great things happening in the midst of them. You know what the enemy puts as a thought in your mind? Let me tell you a fresh thought that the Lord gave me a month ago. I only talked about this with my wife and one other person. When we think about some person, the first thing that comes to our mind is their negative qualities. But after they die, we start to think about their good qualities. When they're alive, if we talk about their good qualities, let them hear it. But the Spirit of the Lord gave me this thought that's new. I know that the Holy Spirit, whenever I want to say something, makes a break and stops me from saying certain things. Because the Holy Spirit even controls our words. We all were lives that were messed up and held by divisions bought by the devil. We only have the grace to speak of the Lord Jesus who washed us by his blood and made us children of God. But none of us are perfect. If you examine carefully, you will find a fault in anybody. If you look at each person, you will see that there might be wrong qualities in them. If we only look at the negative and we declare those, don't do that. This is what the Holy Spirit spoke to me. Child of God, are you speaking about the words of the devil that happened in someone or the words of the spirit that happened in that person?
Of course, Molly, our Pishani has been to take that look, but
my child was headed for destruction before, held with a divisive mind by the devil, but I have bought him by his blood. Yes, he might have some behaviors that come out which might be against the spirit, but are you lifting those up and speaking against my child? If you are always bringing up the negative points, you are just lifting up Satan. Oh, but if you are talking about the good qualities the Lord has done in that person, you are talking about the Spirit and about God. Oh, if you see a negative quality in somebody, pray about them. Don't declare it out in public, but pray for them that they will change. Oh, there should not be any word that is not with the grace of God that comes out of our lips. Oh, we lose many of the blessings that the Lord has for us because of what comes out of our mouths.
Yes,
let me come back to my topic.
I can override the
Lord wants us to be unified when we ask. The second thing is,
avarada vishayathil avar prioritize cheyirunnu endu paranja avarada problem avarku ariya adaya namukku vendi adinu ganeshu vendi.
They had their problems prioritized. They knew what was the number one thing that they wanted to receive from the Lord that day.
Avarada palathil njangalodu karne undarunnu nirulichu parannittu avan veettil ethiyappol
oh, after crying out, have mercy on us, when Jesus got home, the blind man went in with him and went and followed Jesus. They didn't just cry out to the Lord and then just go on their own merry way. Many times when we pray, we cry, we put something in front of the Lord and we go on with our lives. After the Holy Spirit comes, many people dedicate, but then they go on their own ways and they're not persistent after the Lord. Remember, these men are blind men. They cried out for mercy, but that didn't stop them. But they followed Jesus. How did they know, these blind men, to follow Jesus? When I go to UNT to drop off my daughter, I see that there are many people who have dogs that help them, guide dogs. Some people have canes. That is why I understood about the importance of my eyes. They didn't have a cane or a guiding dog, but they followed Jesus. These blind men, I don't know what gutters and other places they have to follow Jesus, but they did persistently follow him. The children of God, you have a need tonight. Is it a need for this world or a need for eternity? This morning, Stephen only said to seek ye first the kingdom of God. And all the things of this world are inside that promise. He didn't go into that. Seek ye first the kingdom of God. And everything else will
come.
What is the need that that needs to be prioritized in our lives? Oh, if I die tomorrow, or if the coming of the Lord is tomorrow, am I ready to meet him in eternity? The word of God says, depart from me, ye that commit iniquity. Is there any iniquities and sins in our lives? Oh, if we don't read the word of God and we don't come and hear messages, we think we're perfect. But when we come into the presence of the Lord and we hear from him and we read the word of God, that is when the Lord reminds us of our sin. When the Lord reminds you of a sin, if you confess it before the Lord right there, he will give you a deliverance and forgiveness. Oh, when Stephen was giving the youth message and giving an altar call, I came forward. The Holy Spirit will speak to me today, I believe. If the Holy Spirit reminds me of something, I will ask the Lord, Lord, forgive me right away. Because there should be nothing that keeps me back